Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Happy Tuesday Mosh Pit to everybody out there. Hope your Tuesdays have gone off to a great start. Man, oh man, speaking of great, we have some amazing artwork of the day, crossover art of the day submitted by Sapphire Sage. Of the Reddit thread was, finally got some inspiration to draw again after a few months. I hear crossover fan art is popular now, and yes, indeed, Sapphire Sage making this amazing piece of art here, the crossover with Cult of the Lamb and Binding of Isaac. I love the Cult of Sissy. I love the Brimstone. I love the Sinvicta logo and Abba Dabba Ding Dong and everything about it. This is incredible. Thank you very much, Sapphire Sage. Definitely go check out the full resolution on the Sinvicta subreddit because you are missing out on some quality art pieces in there. Just the amount of talent that the Mosh Pit artists have are just, it just blows my mind, man. Tango Lima, Papa Lima, Nine Powell. So we're starting off with Pogatory. Also, we are starting off with the Mom's Bottle of Pills, which is going to produce a random pill every full charge that we get. But of course, the bigger story here is going to be Pogatory, aka Purgatory. Purgatory is that red crack on the ground that you see. And if Isaac walks over that, it's going to produce an exploding spirit that will not only destroy most small mobs, not all small mobs, but most small mobs, and on top of that, will also cancel out any of their attacks, which is also very nice indeed. There you go. So it does. It's really weird how Purgatory works sometimes. Sometimes it works in like almost like a delayed. It's like a delayed AoE. Like first the explosion goes off, and then it waits for a second, and then the damage gets applied. And cancels out, like, you know, projectiles and whatnot. So it's very, very good, especially if you have the mobility to get around the room, like, especially with flying. Purgatory becomes a very reliable source of extra damage. It's especially good in early game boss battles, which you don't get to see a whole lot because of that combo utility that you get from the not only the initial explosive damage and AoE, but also, of course, the projectile canceling properties of it. Now, you do have to still be careful because, obviously, it's not an orbital. It won't block projectiles. It simply just stops them from being spawned. Yeah, we'll bomb the donation machine here. We got plenty of money in there. We've been stocking it pretty well. I grab this here. Two keys. That ain't bad. We also have another soul heart, which I will take before the end of this level here. We're still waiting for the next video to cross 5,000 likes as well, everyone. A couple videos are well on their way for sure. I don't know if the secret room's there or not. It is. Well, I didn't mean to pick up that soul heart there, but we'll take it. Also got tractor beam. Tractor beam is going to give us a range and shot speed and tears up. It will also confine our tears to only where the beam goes. So there's no more like we shoot in one direction and then it travels towards the destination and then like we switch to another target in an opposite direction. The tears go literally where the beam goes. So if you see this craziness happening right now, that's the product of that. Gain two bombs here. And maybe get petrified poop. That'll be good if we can. A lot of people have been asking me what my split is for the workout sessions that I'm doing. It's the old workout that I had a long time ago when I was in good shape. Today's Tuesday, so we'd be doing I haven't gone to the gym yet, but we'll be doing chest and triceps. So Monday, I'll run through the routine again. Sunday and Saturday are off, or I can do cardio or play racquetball, something like that. Monday is leg day. Tuesday is chest and tries. Wednesday is back and buys. Thursday is shoulders. Friday is arms. And then do abdominal or core every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Now, that being said, I haven't been doing abs since getting back in the routine and stuff, just because I'm not fully like able to do good sit-ups right now. I hate doing sit-ups. I much prefer doing the leg ups, I guess they're called. Like you know where you put, it's the you're like kind of like on like a, I don't know what the actual technical term is. It's when you've got you're suspended in the air and you've got like the two handles that you can hold on to, one in each arm, and then like you just kind of you do leg raises, leg lifts. Those are good. I prefer the hoops. Like where you put one arm in, you put one arm through each hoop while it's hanging off of like a wire rack or something like that, and then you just do, you know, you do like suspended air leg crunch things. Those are my preferred abdominal exercises. But I haven't been doing those yet because I don't really have the strength in my shoulder to hold myself up for very long without it actually hurting really, really bad. And my shoulder, my right shoulder in particular, is already going through a lot of strain with the racquetball as well as just general lifting and stuff. So I'm trying to take it easy. Again, I'm not rushing back into stuff, but it just feels good, man. It's a weird feeling to be like, man, I can't believe that I've been gone for so long out of the gym. To think what I could have been doing more of, you know, back when back in the day when I was just like, yeah, I've got YouTube, I got to work, got to stream. But before that, had the full-time job and everything, and it's like, man, there's a lot of catching up that me and the gym got to do. But I've been feeling good about it, and you know, I appreciate all the kind words as well. It's neat to hear that people have been getting inspired by me wanting to just simply do something as simple as wanting to go back into the gym and then finally doing it. Purgatory fissure, like, spawned in the same spot that we just got done hitting it. There we go. Purgatory again. We're going to be trying to gun for the purgatory fissures every time we get a chance to, but we got to do it safely. Oh, wow. Just a random soul heart just showing up out of nowhere. Definitely take that. We could go into the store. We got 5 keys. We're not going to be able to get to this purgatory. I for some reason, purgatory loves to spawn in, like, the worst places. Like, on rooms like this, it wants to spawn right in the middle of every single mob that's, like, in existence. I had a feeling Black Candle was in here. Okay, so we need 6 cents. There are plenty of hearts, and we have Yum Heart. Do we go for the sack room here? Black Candle is more important right now. Either way, we're going to get the money to get it, I think, anyway. We need a nickel. Into the Angel Room. We'll get a very rare first floor Angel Room. I'm going to let the bombs drop, actually, because I want to see if they can hit the skulls. Yeah, and they spawned 4 hosts. That's neat. I have no interest in fighting Uriel or Gabriel. Okay, so we need 2 cents. Let's go check out the boss trap room. Okay, we just need 1 cent now because there's a bomb here. This is actually a free bomb. If I can get the bomb. Yeah, there we go. 3 cent, free bomb. And then the box should guarantee give us a coin, and it does. I'm going to use Yum Heart immediately because obviously champion bosses we don't want to mess with. Even though it's only Larry Jr., Green Larry is definitely by far the worst because they all shoot. That and our damage is, like, not incredible. 3.10 is going to get us through the early stages, but that's about it. I'm also just realizing how doo-doo our movement speed is. Okay, we got a soul heart. Yellow Gurgling's also not my favorite because of that right there. Much like we were talking about yesterday, don't be afraid. Oh, wow. Okay, so we can actually use this, go into the curse room. Another long early floor here, but definitely worth it. Don't be afraid, like we were discussing yesterday, about using bombs offensively. It's very, very versatile what you can do with them. There we go. So I think there was a diamond there. So we'll absolutely be able to take Black Candle as well as get all these soul hearts, which I will grab after the boss. Because we don't have to worry about... We basically don't have to worry about qualifying for a double deal anymore. There we go. There we go. I mean, it's only, you know, 10 and a half minutes into the video. 8 minutes, 50 seconds into the run. We'll be fine. I don't know if we'll make boss rush, but hey, we'll try. You see right there, we did not get a double deal, which is honestly totally fine because we're guaranteed one on the next floor now. Gonna do a little bit of backtracking. A little bit of yum-hearting. Black Candle is going to eliminate any and all chances of us ever getting any curses. So no more curses for us for the rest of this run, which is always a good thing. And again, those early sack room plays just really make a big difference. If you have the HP, if you've done a good job at avoiding damage and gotten pretty lucky, you can find yourself profiting very, very nicely on early sack rooms. So there's our 100% deal with the devil chance, and we get that. I had a feeling that was probably not going to pay out with much. You're seeing the damage issues are very, very apparent and obvious. Also, where's Purgatory? Purgatory, did you just decide to not work today? What's going on with you? We needed you in there. Again, Purgatory. The game trying to bait us into getting hit there by having the needle spawn directly below where Purgatory sat. The sack room there. You know what? Hell with it. I'm on tilt from getting hit by the needle. No Angel Room item, unfortunately. Now, there's no reason for us to let the bombs go off in this spot here. Because there's nothing for them to blow up. Again, I don't care about Uriel. And we get more soul hearts. There we go. So, we basically gave ourselves just an angel deal chance. Instead of a devil deal. So, okay. There's not really much else that we could... Didn't really gain anything out of that, let's put it that way. But it's all about the possibilities and hope of actually profiting out of there. But no harm, no foul. We actually got our HP back that we had lost. So, no, we did, it, at the cost of a little bit of time, we did get something out of it. I'm going to get this soul heart just because I'm probably, knowing myself, not going to feel like coming back here to go get it. Which is not the right attitude to have as an Isaac player, by the way, but... Hey, I never said I wasn't lazy in Isaac sometimes. All right. So still looking for a good amount of damage. Just any damage up, any movement speed would be great. We're going to heavily rely upon Purgatory to... get us through the early rough patches here. Yeah, I'm going to be really leaning on Purgatory's ability, as you saw right there, to remove any projectiles from death rattles or anything like that. Oh boy. All right. Lead pencil is going to be a nice damage helper, but not upgrade. I don't really want to take the Soul of Judas just because we're going to need the strength card for either damage against the boss or for Devil Deal purposes later on. I mean, we've got Angel Deals right now, obviously, but people have been wanting to see Angel Deals, and I'm fine with that, but Angel Deals has got to start producing stuff other than just, you know, HP. There you go. So you see the lead pencil activating every 15 shots. Throw out a massive amount, just a spray of tears. And if we needed some stat up, some stat help, well, look no further than that item right there. Apparently there's a penny underneath the keeper. That happens sometimes whenever you, I've noticed that there are some times where you would like say, get like a, like if you make a withdrawal from a donation machine or like if you bomb a coin or something like that, it will actually slide underneath like keepers and stuff. They just completely hide them. It happens with slot machines and fortune telling machines as well. Oh man, Transcendence. Now we're talking. This is not a damage buff, but it is going to be flying. And if you recall me talking about how important it is to have mobility with Purgatory, that's a huge get for us. I'm all about this. So now Isaac is not limited to environmental blockades, and we can access Purgatory more rapidly, which is in turn going to increase the ability of us to deal damage. So in a weird roundabout sort of way, it is a damage upgrade for us. We get eye drops, which, yeah, we'll take it, and yeah, that's just a whole lot of HP, which is what I was worried about. And this is the downside of having to do, not having to, but getting Angel Deals. But luckily we got Purgatory. Gotta have faith. You gotta have faith, like Fred Durst used to say. Gotta jump. I am gonna take Book of Belial just because we need the damage. Yeah, Transcendence is about as basic as it gets in terms of flying. It's literally just flying. But it's really rare to see, and combined with the right stuff like Purgatory, again, it tangentially increases your damage in a sort of roundabout sort of way. Now, we definitely need movement speed. If we get more movement speed, then like we can really, really... That's when you can start discussing about how movement speed in this build might actually be considered a damage upgrade. I mean, we're doing a lot of gymnastics in order to make this explanation happen, but it makes sense to my brain. A great hit by Purgatory there. And Halo of Flies, another defensive upgrade, which is seems to be the theme of the run so far, anyway. The Book of Belial will essentially double our damage based on us using the book every three room cooldowns, three pips, three charges, whatever you want to call it. This is Purgatory at? It's all the way the heck up here. It's going to explode before it even gets there. Yeah, maybe not. Get our standard typical greed fight here. So what we really like at this point I would honestly take a movement speed upgrade before a damage upgrade. Our tears rate is okay, thanks to us getting eye drops. This is the time where I'm not going to talk about like the possible downsides of eye drops, just because we needed the tears up. Our base tears rate was effective enough to where we don't have to worry about the staggered nature of eye drops that much. It's not going to impede our DPS all that much. And, of course, with Tractor Beam, it's going to help us out. And on top of that, we've also got Lead Pencil. So our damage looks surprisingly okay for us having a base stat of, you know, four damage. Obviously, money's going to be very important because we've got Keeper Sack, and Keeper Sack is going to be the big thing that we've got to lean on if we don't get the damage upgrades from, like, say, an Angel Deal or a Boss Room or a Devil Deal. There's no sacrifice room on this floor, so we're going to get a Devil Deal here no matter what, and it is going to be an increased slight chance here, thanks to Book of Belial. Thank you, Pogatory. Champion Gertie Juniors. The blue ones you got to be careful about because they do move a little bit trickier, but they also drop a Soul Heart. But yeah, the movement speed here, the lack of movement speed is just god-awful. And we get another HP upgrade. All right. All right. More HP. So we're at the point of the stage of the run now where you gotta start thinking long term. You gotta start thinking that the game is just at this point only going to give you HP and only HP. So we have to start looking at possible other avenues of where can we get any damage from. We need to focus on not spending any money until we get to stores and buy everything out of every single store. Hope that we get something like the Silver Dollar, which is going to spawn an extra store inside of the womb levels. You know, maybe even, as crazy as it sounds, maybe even go fight Old Hushy only for the sole purpose of going and getting another store to lean upon Keeper Sack even more. And that sounds ridiculous, but this run is also starting to get a little ridiculous with the lack of stats that we're getting here from the bosses and or missed Devil Deals. You gotta face those Gish Flies head on. You try to dodge in any which way, they're gonna get you with the diagonal little death rattle that they do. But this is where Purgatory comes in. Purgatory stops all that mess. All that junk. A little Monstro, who is, not a damage upgrade, but he's certainly there. Purgatory, all you had to do was just hit the spider. I had the Dark Matter Ball under control. Another greed fight, but this is good because this tells us that there's no greed fight inside the store, which is exactly what we don't want right now. Because we need to do the aforementioned Keeper Sack play here and just spend as much money as possible to get as many stat ups as we can. And it's runs like this that really show off like how good of an item Keeper Sack is. Also, there's the southern end of the map, everyone. There you go. Bringing you my absolutely free treasure map and compass services every single run. No problem at all. Great block by Halo of Flies there. The Rainbow Champion, that's the reason why it's glowing like that. Rainbow Champions will drop a smorgasbord of different things, but unfortunately that one didn't drop too many good things. We buy everything here, everything that we can. There we go. So we gained a good amount of damage out of that, actually. 6.6 damage now is real good. Up to an 86.2% chance for a devil deal, which is a very, very weird percentage to see.
Ace of hearts.
Super secret room should be here. Okay, this is going to give us more money. And as much as I don't want another HP upgrade, this will also possibly give us a movement speed upgrade, which we definitely desperately need right now. You see old bandage there tossing out the red hearts. I appreciate that. Those are big time plays, son. There it is. Gonna give us a full heal. Well, almost a full heal. Alright, movement speed is a go. I'm not going to spend anything on judgment because I want to save this for the shops. There you go. There's our 100% deal with the devil lock. Now we're taking bets to see how many people will think that it's going to be a Krampus fight. Who's got a Krampus fight? I have no idea what just hit me there. Did we get hit before that fatty even landed? Did it pull the whole physics thing? I wish I could go back and rewatch that. I'll have to look at it on the replay. Maybe there was creep or something there? I don't know. Sometimes Isaac just makes up the damage it hits you with. Kinda, it's one of those perks. A double trouble for the turdlings. Fairly tame boss battle, especially with Purgatory. You get another movement speed upgrade. We get the Pact and Spirit of the Night. I'm going to take both of these because even though we already have flying, Spectral Tears are huge for Isaac. And then the Pact is just a straight up damage increase for us. So we'll absolutely positively take that. Now that the new Path of Exile League is out, new players have been discovering Invicta's Metal. It's a unique Path of Exile two-handed axe. Like, it's like Enzymite Axe or something like that. I forget what the base weapon is called. It's always fun seeing the reaction of people who are like, "Do you know you had a Path of Exile weapon named after you?" I do. I did. Thank you. It's a reference to not only my preferred brand of music genre, but also my band. If you look at the flavor text on the Sinvicta's Metal Axe, you'll see what I'm talking about. A reference to the Ward of Lauder. Sigmana is going to give us damage and HP. And we just cannot stop getting HP upgrades. Even after we got rid of some of our HP, we're right back up to where we were just by getting in these random Eternal Hearts from Angel Deals and Stigmatas showing up in wooden chests and all stuff. The champion took that hit from Purgatory like a champ. Get it? Because it's a champion, champ. You get it? Thank you. And Spectral Tears are going to allow us to shoot through environmental objects, make sure that they don't, make sure that they don't collide with our tears. It's very, very useful. And we end up getting the IV bag, which is going to be very nice for Keeper Sack. Old Bandage finally woke up and gave us something. Also have this Card Against Humanity, which is also going to provide us with a ton of more resources for the IV bag. So we essentially have infinite money now, which means that if we find a restock machine or get restock, well, not restock, but if we end up finding a restock machine, however, we are going to be in stat heaven, and our early run woes there are going to be long gone. Mystery sack is kind of whatever. I would take chaos, not because I want chaos, but because I want the stats that chaos will give us from us buying things. So now shops really, really matter. Panic button. Okay. Well, we had a good thing going with this combo here. We're setting up nicely for a good victory lap is what we're doing. The first run here is going to be a little bit rough against Lamb if we decide to do victory lap, which I probably will because we've got our damage is good enough for sure. But I really want to see how far we can push it with Chaos and with the IV bag. That's a great dodge there. I'm not even going to try to lie to you and say that was on purpose. I was expecting Halo of Flies to help me out there, not just straight up dodge them. Yeah, we can get some money out of this. By this, I mean the soul heart. There we go. We have no more shops on the horizon for now, unless we go fight Hush, which I severely doubt that we're going to actually make it to Hush. Even if we tried, I don't think we're going to make it there. Especially when we go the wrong way. Secret room's not there, which is a little bit surprising. I would have bet the house on that one. Okay. Maybe this is the right way to go. We got 20 bombs, and I will absolutely exercise my right to use them. To skip rooms and go through less annoyance of bad navigational skills. There's our secret room. There's a pass-through. Okay, that's good. Obviously, the devil deals and angel deals no longer matter because of chaos, which is the downside of taking chaos, which is the reason why I always kind of hesitate there. But again, I really wanted to get the stats from Keeper Sack, so... Now, we also have a sacrifice room here, which could take us straight to Lamb. And honestly, that's not a bad idea. We'd be skipping Womb 2... We'd be skipping Womb 2. There's no real consequence to that because we'd be skipping Shoal as well. I mean, I guess if you want to call it a consequence, the only real consequence is that we don't get our Eden token back. But other than that, I mean, it's like, who cares about that? Playing the sacrifice room to Lamb may be a better play here than going through Womb 2 and Shoal. If our intent is to do a victory lap, which it is. I use the IV bag there because I don't want to lose. I don't want to get dinged on the. On our soul heart. What I need to do is I just need to find a big room that we can use Card Against Humanity in, so we can have all those hearts ready to go for the sacrifice room play. We need to do that after we're done with the boss, though. We don't want to skip this boss. And it's almost a foregone conclusion that we should. We should get a full heal, at the very least, out of the Card Against Humanity. Unless the game is just feeling really, really mean and doesn't give us any hearts or the petrified poop. Get a luck upgrade here. We did get a devil deal. Speedball. I'm gonna say no to both Brown Nugget and Speedball. So what we want in here, we want hearts, but we want red hearts first. There it is. Now we're guaranteed to get the full heal along with a bunch of money that we're obviously we're at 99 cents, so this doesn't really matter. But the hearts are the big thing. The reason why the hearts are the big thing is because we want the fodder for Card Against Humanity. Or for the sacrifice room, I mean. Okay, so now we play the sac room, and I think that we are going to go straight to the lamb. Because to me, because I mean, we weren't gonna hit, we weren't gonna fight Hushy anyway. We've already lost that ability to, unless we somehow randomly found Mama Mega. There's no reason for us to care about Womb 2 unless we actually care about the Eden tokens, which we got plenty of them. So yeah, I think that there's no reason not to do this. You get the soul hearts. So what we want to do here is we want to. I don't really want to get the soul hearts yet. Oh, we got plenty of them in the other room. It doesn't matter. Okay, so let's tap this for Uriel, or for Gabriel, I mean. Go back and get filled up on HP. Then we go straight to the dark chest via the sac room. There's plenty of other soul hearts in that room, so we don't need that many here. I'm just trying to fill up on red hearts just in case. There we go. Very nice. That is very nice. I'm liking these sacrifice room plays. There we go. So we have skipped Womb 2 as well as Shoal. Maggie's bow. I mean, this is it's a free get, plus we get the heal. I think we take all of these, to be honest. PH Dizzle. The health up, because, I mean, why not at this point? We've got plenty of health, that's for sure. And a dead end, all right. The door is going to give us a nice damage up here and another dead end. Okay, so this room was an absolute disaster, and that's why I absolutely despise Double Fallen. Because if you split them up, and they're all flying all around the room together, you don't know when the brimstones are going to go off, and you also can't control where all your damage is going to, because there's just too many targets in the room. So, yeah. Not very happy with that room at all. Okay, you saw Ragman just firing into nothing there. I will take the pinking that's a tough one. Because yes, pinking shears will help us get through Lamb, but if we manage to not die in the dark chest and get to the victory lap, then the IV bag becomes way, way, way better. Because remember, we've got Keeper Sack. The whole point of us holding on to the IV bag is for Keeper Sack. What is going on with this chub? Very early jump there by Blastoise. Blastoise? Yeah. It was a very early jump by Charizard there. Playing too many. I told you I've been playing lots of Pokemon Go. We got to get the adversaries on the same screen because they'll do that brimstone stuff off screen. Pretty much every single time you give them a chance to. Dice shard, which will re-roll They reroll stuff on the ground, but also reroll item pedestals. Dice. It's hard not to take the picking shears there. Looking for a secret room. Got PhD, so this is actually not a bad drop for us. Get the mother transformation. Another health up. I can see Forever actually is going to help out quite a bit, because that's going to show me exactly where secret rooms are and open them up. There it is. All right. Fantastic. That red Monstro 2, which is not one of my favorites. Luckily, though, he starts off with these brimstone flies that will ruin his world. You see there that we got two red hearts instead of one per heart. That's because of Maggie's bow. That's the reason why it's a good pickup. Being able to heal for double the amount of hearts that you pick up is just so strong, especially when you like you need it the most. Double black champion Limehorn. Get marbles. Marble's gonna spawn a bunch of trinkets that we can swallow if we take damage, and Lord knows we've been taking lots of that. So we get the cancer trinket, which is actually gonna bring us over the tears cap and help us out greatly because we have lead pencil. And we have the power pill as backup in case we need it against Lamb, which we probably shouldn't at this point. Again, Purgatory is such a huge counter to Lamb, because watch all the projectiles just disappear that he tries to fire off at you. Watch this. Yeah, it just gives you like this barrier window of no projectiles from enemies that's just too good not to use. Purgatory, especially when Lamb is sitting on top of himself, hitting both the body as well as the head is really, really good. He always manages to clip me with the side of the brimstone there. There we go. Down goes Lamb, and you bet we're going to do one. Even though it was a little rough there, second C is going to be Lima 3, Juliet Kilo Vale. Actually spelled Vale. So I'm actually going to pause the recording real quick. I need to use the restroom real fast. Apologies about this. Sorry about that. All that water from the gym and from getting back home, hydrating, all that kind of good stuff. Explosive. Time for Lazarus's rags here. Now remember, we have chaos, so we're going to be seeing a lot of items that we probably won't be seeing in unusual places, including like, you know, Angel Dio items inside of like item rooms. Heart up, or health up, I mean. Devil deals inside the shop, etc., all that kind of stuff. Almost got me, game. So devil deals no longer really matter anymore, neither do angel deals. What we're really, really looking for is we want to have enough money to be spending on keepers, basically in the shop as much as possible. And what we're hoping for is a reroll machine inside, or a restock machine, I should say, inside of the shop, so we can cycle through those rarer items, like Miter, for example. All right, so here we go. This is what we kept IV bag around for, and this is the time for big time plays. I'm going to save our money for premium items and ignore the smaller ones for now. Camo undies, again, I'm just taking these purely for the reason of us wanting to get more stats out of Keeper Sack. Now remember, we're healing 2 for 1 every single heart that we get. buy the razor blade, but I'm not going to use it. I'm not going to buy a $3 bill. Or Babylon is a good buy here. Jawbone, sure. Again, only for the stats. Soy milk, sure. We'll buy soy milk. Why not? We'll take soy milk or not. Try that again. The game was like, are you sure you want soy milk? Yes, actually I do. With lead pencil and the ability to give ourselves damage stats with the keeper sack, absolutely want soy milk. Jawbreaker, oh boy. We did swallow the cancer trinket as well, so our tears rate is a paltry 34.94. It's pretty good. Jawbreaker just going off just everywhere. I remember these half hearts that we're picking up from just randomly. They're going to be healing for full hearts. An old bandage is also going to be a nice little resource there for us to utilize. And it all just comes down to just turning money into stats. If you have soy milk and you can get your damage above like 4, you're doing real well for yourself. Dude, that's incredible. I don't know if chocolate milk does anything with soy milk. I almost don't want to find out just because I don't want to have to charge my shots. We get placebo here. Again, buying it just for stats. We're now at 3. Well, I guess we can get chocolate milk and find out. 2.09 damage now. Just does nothing. Okay. Fair enough. Come on, old bandage. Had faith in you, old bandage. What happened to you? You fell off, man. Good amount of money there. My god. Name is Bookworm. For the Bookworm transformation, I will take the Intruder. Intruder's not going to fire any faster just because we have soy milk, so it's just kind of there. Yeah, contract from below. Hooking us up where IV bag cannot right now. There we go. That's the old bandage. That's all you got to do. Drop those hearts. Look at that. Back up to almost full hearts now. All of a sudden, we went from basically no money to a whole lot of money. We get tech 0. Oh, boy. Now, I don't want to have to... I don't want to have to intervene, but Tech Zero with this amount of firepower does tend to crash the game. So just be aware of that. Keeper's Kin. Spider Babby. Potato Peeler as well. And Fat Odd Mushroom, which I will take. There we go. Oh man, oh man, we're almost at 4 damage. We did get Lost Soul Buddy. If you're wondering why Lost Soul Buddy has a shield around him, it's because we have BBF. Or BFF, I should say. Not BBF. So that helps. That greatly increases the chance of Lost Soul Buddy actually living through a level instead of being totally useless like he normally is. I'm hoping that we get some kind of piercing shots as well. That would be nice. I wouldn't mind Sharp Straw, but it wouldn't do too much with our base damage being so low. Gilded Key. I'm not sure if the Gilded Key is a good play here with Guppy's Tail, but we can hold on to it. We've got the keys for now anyway. We've got the keys. Yeah. Doing this so I can buy one soul heart. Because it's essentially free and it just gave us even more damage, so. My problem is I can't tell where I am on the floor because we're. Whenever you take damage, like, here's the thing about Transcendence. Whenever you take damage with Transcendence, it becomes, Isaac's body just disappears. It's kind of like that bug, that visual bug that you see with the flying pony. Oh, man. It's going to be just a, well, get ready for 99 cents, because, yeah. And this is the sort of profit that I was talking about earlier. Like, if we could just live through the victory lap, through the lamb, I mean, and make it on the next lap with IV bag, we can turn everything, every piece of hearts and HP pickups that we find into raw stats. Did end up gulping the gilded key. So I have a feeling that our item room is going to be down here. By down here, I mean, of course, over here. Who would think it was over there? The only mushroom that we were near is the one that did the bad gas. That's a funny game. I don't think I didn't notice that. Here, Tech Zero. We essentially have Jacob's Ladder at this point. Oh my god! Well, if you were unsure about the pickup of soy milk before, don't worry, we've got 8.59 damage with soy milk in this fire rate. That is, that's a spicy taco right there. Oh no, Lost Soul Buddy, oh no. So yeah, Sacred Heart's gonna bring our damage up just a little bit, just a hair. Now have 7.60 luck. Okay, well, we just got a whole lot more tears rate. So all the tears rate that we lost on Sacred Heart has now instantly been returned to us. What a ridiculous run this has turned into. And to think that we had damage problems in the early goings. Oh, man. This is going to give us even more damage and more knockback. This is starting to get stupid. I got to take ladder. Well, I'm fine. Better. Divorce papers, which is just going to give us even more tears. A second keeper sack. We've got two sacks now. Sure. One away from spun as well. The only downside now is that we have no more soul hearts. We do have to be a little bit cautious about how many times that we withdraw out of our HP bank here. But it's a foregone conclusion that the game is not going to be able to do anything to kill us. We're going to have to do it to ourselves here if we're going to get in trouble. I mean, this gives us a range upgrade. And yeah, there's spun. All right. Got speed up. Speed up, friends, till the end. Oh, we're up at 12 luck now. Yeah, that's a dead fallen. This is absolutely going to crash the game, so I'm going to take it. Lackfergy plus this. Yeah. So, Lackfergy is now going to turn our tears into, like, these sort of spiderweb-esque AoE explosion tiers, which is pretty good. It'd be better if we found piercing shots, though. Piercing shots would definitely be an improvement over what we've got. Not saying that we need it, of course. It would just be nice to have. We also picked up Little Horn, which is going to give us a Big Horn, like, proc. Yeah, just wait for Lead Pencil to start firing into the into itself, basically, with the Lackfergy ears. Easy for me to say. The brain needed a rewire there for a second. Soul of Isaac. Gonna let us re-roll. This is starting to get out of control. I'm hoping that we end up finding piercing shots, because if we do, there's like, you think this is good damage here right now? Like, you ain't got no idea what this is gonna look like if we get piercing shots. If we end up getting piercing shots on this, oof, brother, sister, we got a lot of stuff to look forward to. We're 2 feet there because of Tarot Cloth, by the way. Just wanted to keep Lost Soul Buddy honest. E-Bizzle. No, I actually wanted sulfuric acid. That would allow me to shoot through doors. And I wanted sulfuric acid. E-Bizzle. 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 Do we need D-Bizzle? No. We don't need him. We don't need anything in this room. What you need to do is smash that like button, bros. Make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell as well. Pop a fly. There was a devil deal. Oh, no. What is this going to do for Loki's horns? Yeah. Yeah. I saw that one coming from a mile away. I was like, oh boy, this is going to be interesting, and it sure is. Lost Soul Buddy giving us a satanic bibble. Thank you, Lost Soul Buddy, for being here. Get Blood Oath out of nowhere. Now, we don't really want Blood Oath. Not saying that it wouldn't be like an amazing amount of damage, because it would, but we don't really need it. Tendon Rock in there. Haven't seen a Tendon Rock in here. Pull the Keeper, gives us a random amount of money. Just like a flying V of death. Any and all tier effects we need or have. And there is a forget me now. So if we hurry, we can do two boss rushes. We gotta find the fool card or some way to teleport out. Got our fool card. I do want to see what's in the store. Demon baby. They give us conjoined, which is fine by me because I wanted it for tractor beam as well as lacrimogy. Mike rune. Nah. Shot speed up. Sure. The five room is going to be a forget me now, which is going to restart the floor. And if we're fast enough, we can go get ourselves another boss rush. Wow. A devil deal there, and not a great boss rush, I'm going to be honest. So let's just go try that again. But before we do that, I want to go get my Soul of Isaac. I'm going to have our rerolls ready.
Speed up.
All right. Now we don't even really need the piercing shots anymore. Us fan. We want the Soul of Isaac for the boss rush. So we're not going to teleport out of the boss rush this time around, so which means that we need to make sure that we have everything done on this floor before we go fight Mom. Sacrifice room here. Getting a lot of golden chests here because of us swallowing the gilded key. I do not even know where I am on the screen right now. Us being totally invisible when we get hit with transcendence is making me lose my mind here. Let's check out the crawl space real quick. No, I wasn't really thinking it, but I mean, we went to everywhere but the store, as you do. Camo undies is also not helping out with the visibility thing. See, the only problem here is that we didn't go fight Stanley or Mom's Heart in Shoal and Womb 2, respectively. So, Omega Run You'd have to do another lap for an Omega run.
Balls of steel.
We actually need to hurry so we get this boss rush done. Let's see if we can. We still need to get the. We'd still need to get the angel keys too. The negative. We already have the Polaroid. I know that I said I was going to save the soul of Isaac for the boss rush. But I'm thinking about saving it for Old Hushy now. Now that we have the R key, that kind of changed plans a little bit. Don't know what's hitting me. Again, I have no clue what's hitting me. All right. And that's how you beat Boss Rush. So I think that the operative plan here let's see if we can get a sacrifice room and go get a key for Mega Stand. If we get past the Mega Stand block, then we'll try for an Omega run. We need a sacrifice room to do that with, though. Hungo Baby and Linger Bean. I wish we had some kind of mapping. Okay, well, thank you, game. Appreciate it. I do wish that we had some kind of compass effect. Okay. Soul of Isaac. I guess we can go check for a sack room up here. The reason why we're looking for a sacrifice room is because we need to find it for... didn't even see that bomb there. We need to get the angel keys. Mega Stan. So if we find that, that'd be great. We still have to beat Hush, though. Fair car is not going to do it, Lost Soul Buddy, but thank you for trying. Let's see. It's not going to be down here. The boss is not going to be down here. This is really why I wish I would have taken sulfuric acid. There's a library here. Zach Alter. He's the soul of Isaac in here. Of Isaac. The Book of Shadows. Okay. Take our Empress card. Should probably be picking up these keys too. Because of the gilded key, we're gonna be finding a lot of this. We could also take the soul of Lazarus just for a backup in case if we need it, but I don't think anything's gonna be touching us. If anything, we're gonna be running into things. And again, I don't care about losing devil deals. It doesn't matter because we have chaos. There was something over here, but it was not a sacrifice room. The spades doubles our keys. All right. So now goes Mom's heart. Gotta go beat old Hushy. Then we go up to Isaac. We got the compass and spin down die. Unfortunately, it's a day late and a dollar short. Oh man, never mind. Get school bag and then we also take spin down die. On earth. Well, there's our piercing shots that we wanted. Speed up. We'll take Damocles. Actually, that has Dad's key. So we don't have to worry about the angel statues. Okay. Thank you, spin down die. Yeah, this is what piercing shots is going to do here. Just keep an eye on Hush's HP. Yeah. Down goes old Hushy. There is a sacrifice room up here. We're dealing so much damage, it doesn't... Like, only something like the Haunt could do that. It actually damage us. This is Delirium Portal. We still need to get past the Mega Stand block regardless of this. We can do a victory lap and go kill Stanley as well as Mom's Heart. No, we're just missing Stanley on that one. Never mind. There you go. So we unlock that. We have to go beat Blue Baby first. No Delirium Portal from Blue Baby. Now let's see if the game feeling generous. We have no keys, unfortunately. What is hitting me down there? I don't know what's hitting me, but we don't get the delirium. And I wish that was a guaranteed. Well, either way, it was one heck of a run, everyone. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this run, make sure you click the like button. Get this video over 5,000 likes so we can keep on adding to the tally down below for the Wheel of Most Disliked Items run. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. Have a great start to your Tuesday, everybody. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Known Roach, Jose Zen, Daniel Kwan, Mark J. Cameron, and Matt Blanford. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find down below, or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.